Hello children, how are you? Hope you all are fit and fine with your family. You want to know about me? Yes, I am also fine. Children, some of the students are doing their work regularly, but some of the students are not doing their work. What happened, children? We know this is a very tough time for us. So we will not waste our time. We teachers are doing hard work for you. So this is your responsibility to complete your work regularly. Now I will continue my chapter. Motherboard. Motherboard is also known as the main circuit board, base board or system board. It is placed at the back or base of the computer cabinet. It is a printed circuit board that provides a platform for various components or ICs. ICs means integrated circuits of a computer. Motherboard allows the power allocation to the CPU, RAM and other hardware component of a computer. This is the motherboard. This is the printed area which we can see in computer's cabinet back or base. Now next is ports. Ports are the connecting nodes to interface the peripheral devices with the processor. They are also known as communication ports. They act as a bridge between the external device and the CPU for data communication. Means they help to communicate external devices and CPU together. The different types of ports available in computer are, first is serial ports. Serial ports is used to supply data serially, that is bit by bit. It uses a single wire for communication. It can 8-pin pattern that we have seen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8-pin pattern are here of bits, or a byte is to be transferred, then it does it in 8 tries. This port takes much time to transfer data. This is taking so much time to transfer the data. That is, it takes 8 times longer to transfer a byte. Serial ports are usually available in 9 pins or 24 pins and basically allows connection of mouse, modem, etc. Then second is parallel ports. This type of ports is available with a 24 pins. There are 9 pins and 24, but it is only 24 pins, female connector, and it is capable to transmitting 8 bit signal at a time, that only 1 bit at one time at a time, but it can send 8 bit signals at a time. That is, the bits travel parallel to each other. The transfer rate is 8 times faster than a serial port. This port is basically provided to connect CD writers, scanners, printers, hard disk, etc. Nowadays the mouse will also connected by this parallel port. Then USB port. This port is specially designed to connect printers, plotter, mouse, joystick, pen drives, digital camera and many other external devices with a single plug attachment. It avoids pin configuration of the ports, because when we are using pin system, then it will be very difficult, and pins are damaged when we are inserting CD drive, scanner and printer. Then it will damage the pins. And when pins damage, it will not work properly. So that nowadays USB port are very beneficial, and they are very easy to connect. This is also known as universal serial bus. Now after port, modem. As we know, a computer only understand and accept digital signals coming from different sources. Because computer can't understand any language, it understand only digital signals. In these circumstances, you need to intermediate device that converts analog signal to digital signals. because we have seen that when signals are coming from the air, that is in the form of analog signals. But computer doesn't work on analog signal, it work only digital signal. So that modem help us to convert this analog signal to digital signal and vice versa. Thus a modem is a device that modulate outgoing digital signal from a computer or other digital devices to analog signals. It also demodulates the incoming analog signal and convert them to digital signal for the digital device. Analog signal, what is analog signal? Any type of signal or wave which are coming from the atmosphere is continuously varying in nature is known as an analog signal. It always gives the output as a pattern, and by observing the pattern of the output wave we can conclude the result. Now, types of modem. There are three types of modem. First is internal modem. An internal modem is attached to the internal slot of the motherboard. Means it is connected internally with the motherboard. These modem are categorized as full duplex and half duplex modem, which are used for fax and internet communications. They can also be used for data and voice communications. Second is external modem. External modem is a small box connected to the communication port of the computer. It will connected from the outside. Externally it will be connected. It works similar to the internal modem. The only difference is that the external modem is placed outside the CPU box. It will not be needed to connect it inside. Third is USB modem. The term USB modem refers to any type of data, fax, voice modem devices which can be connected to a computer using the USB port. No need to connect internally, no need to connect externally. It will be connected by the USB port. The term is commonly used for a specific portable device that looks similar to a USB flash drive but is smaller in size. These small portable USB modems do not require power.